on boys. The new word entered my sense of self, bisexual. I am bi, and that is the truth of who I am. It means that when I have a crush on someone, they might be the same gender as me, or they might be a different gender to me. Now, why am I bringing this up? As someone who is bi, I get to celebrate that part of my identity in many ways. And one is, every February, so starting tomorrow, the UK holds LGBT History Month, marking and celebrating the histories of gay, bi, and transgender people, and the fight for equality that has achieved so much and is still ongoing. I prefer to use the word queer instead of LGBT to be inclusive of all identities that are not the gender default. But the word queer isn't accepted by everyone, because it has for many years been used as an insult to cause great harm. And I acknowledge that, while still reclaiming it now as a neutral term for a lot of people in 2018. So, LGBT History Month. The history of queer people, the history itself, is one of the factors that forms my identity. It connects me to the queer community, because we share it. So it's important that I learn about it. It's also important for gay people, and people who aren't trans, including me, to hear and learn histories that aren't directly our own, because we're all living together in society. And it's important to me as a Christian. It's important to me that I tell my story to counteract other religious people who disagree with me, who think that there is something wrong if you are queer. When I hear about the suffering of queer people caused by other religious people, when I hear about my Christian brothers and sisters hating and attacking my queer brothers and sisters, it makes me look cold. To be honest, it breaks my heart. Queer history is littered with violence against us, justified by religion. I can tell you very clearly that the way of Christ does not justify violence, discrimination, or condemnation of someone because of the truth of who they are. And it does not uphold that there is something wrong with us. Quite the opposite. The good news of Christ breaks open the boundaries between us. The boundary between heaven and earth is broken when God is made human being. The boundary between life and death is ripped open in the glory of Easter morning when Jesus raised from the dead. And when Jesus travels and teaches, he crosses the boundary between genders, proving those boundaries to be entirely imaginary. Many women were very separated over time, and for a man to talk to listen to eat with a woman was very scandalous. And Jesus did all of these things. Did you know the longest conversation Jesus had with anybody in the Bible is with a woman? It would have been absolutely outrageous. One of his key messages was that who your relationships are with is relevant, and we should instead worry about whether our relationships are good, respectful, loving, cooperative. Are they relationships that build each other up to be the glorious beauty of its humanity at its best, when people are able to be themselves? Queer people are so named because we are not the default. The default is that there is a boundary between the gender man and the gender woman, and that everyone sits in one of these two categories, and so everyone meets a set of gender expectations. Queer history shows that we have been subverting those gender expectations in our fundamental identities for as long as there have been people. We have proved that those gender expectations are false. Breaking those boundaries isn't new. It has been part of many cultures for thousands of years in places spread out and as old as ancient societies in Australia, Canada, Siberia, Peru. And many cultures have always had more than two genders. Hopefully you can hear that as I talk about my Christian and bisexual, I feel that people are slightly angry and incredibly amused. Jesus ate with outcasts, wielded a whip at people to drive around the temple, brought people back from the dead, and upset the religious people so much they had him killed for it. And you're telling me I'm scandalous? He was neither man nor God, but he both in one person. I am neither attracted just to other genders, nor attracted to just my own gender, but fully both in one person. He tore down gender expectations as false, and I am following his footsteps. I am also following the footsteps of Brenda Howard, the five women known as Mother of Pride, and people like David Bowie, Billy Holiday, Freddie Mercury, through God's eyes, to understand the little